some people are saying Australia is no place for a marae. What do you say to that?
Why? The next generation, and we come across this all the time, but they don't know where they're from, they don't know their hapu, their iwi, they don't know how to connect to their own identity. Some are very fortunate like us, where whānau continue to come back and replenish, but a vast majority don't. Whilst we keep growing our population in Australia, the connection with home diminishes. Without a place and events to recreate the whanaungatanga, then how do they access it? The design is three buildings, the main whare, and then there is a whare wānanga, and there is a whare kai.
As Māori, we know what it's like for our land to get taken away from us.
Mm.
Do you think it's appropriate to have a Māori cultural centre on Aboriginal whenua?
Regardless of whether it's your whare, your business, you're driving on the roads, all of us are on Aboriginal whenua. Some of the concerns have been based on some of the things that are misunderstood, like we've taken land. We have not taken the whenua, we're literally leasing that parcel of land for 20 years. Why is a cultural centre not a place that we can create for our people to be and know who they are and thrive? Why is that a bad thing? It is unreasonable to think that all of our Māori can come home. I don't see the negative aspect of having a cultural centre at all. It has nothing but positive opportunities. Is it appropriate for us to ensure that our own culture thrives in another land? It is absolutely important. It's our responsibility. We have partnered with the local iwi for 30 years back. Our intention has been to walk in partnership. We are told from our people, we need this. We need this. Our people need this. My kids need this. My mokos need this. And so there's a very strong voice from our people that we need it urgently.
Ko te reo, te take.